गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, दिस इज़ योर ज्योति टीचर. चिल्ड्रेन, इन द प्रीवियस सेशन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन लेसन 6 पोएम द जंपलीज एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द पोएम द जंपलीज. सी, ऑलरेडी वी नो द जंपलीज हाउ दे वर्क इन दैट क्रॉकरी जार. दे हैड वो पिंकी पेपर्स दैट हैव रैप्ड टू देयर फीट and they have tied with a pin. So now what happened, we see. Though the sky be dark and the OAS be long, yet we never can think we were rash or wrong. While rounding our sieve we spin, far and few, far and few. All the lands where the jumblies live, their heads are green and their hands are blue, and they went to sea in a sieve. Once again, though the sky be dark and the waves be long, yet we never can think we were rash or wrong. While rounding our sieve we spin, far and few, far and few. Or the lands where the jumblies live, their heads are green and their hands are blue, and they went to sea in a sieve. Here, see what OAS. OAS means a long journey involving travel by sea. Sometimes air also it comes, but here OAS means a long journey involving travel by sea. But it's a long journey. Why they told OAS means? That the jumblies had traveled for a long distance. Now see the explanation. The jumblies said that even their journey was for a long period and it was the dark night, they never think that they had any mistake or they were careless. It means here, see, even for the long time in the darkness they have travel for a long time also, they never think that they have done any mistake by entering into the sea. And they told that they are never careless. They are always taking care and very careful about themselves, they told. It means they are not accepting. They are not accepting that they have done a mistake by getting to the sea. And that too in a sieve. Now, at last, by saying that what they told, they repeated that their heads are green and hands are blue. And they went in a sieve to see where they want to go, to the place where the jumblies live. So, in this manner, the jumblies said that even they had taken a long period of journey and even in the dark night also, they feel that they did not have any mistake. Why? Because their so many friends had called them to come back. But without listening to them, they came into sea. Now see children, next. And all night long they sailed away. And when the sun went down, they whistled and warbled a moony song. To the echoing, echoing means resound, repeatedly comes the sound, echoing sound of a coppery gong. Coppery gong means a bell made of copper, especially we can see in temples and church, a bell which was made of copper, in the shade of the mountains brown. Once again, and all night long they sailed away, and when the sun went down, they whistled and warbled a moony song to the echoing sound of a coppery gong in the shade of the mountains brown. What is this? I will explain. First, see the meanings. Sail means having a sail, traveling. Warbled, warbled means sang in a shaky voice. Sometimes, see, when it is very shivering outside, when we sing a song, how our voice comes in a shaking manner. So that is called as warbled. Here the jumblies were in a sieve. So because of the coldness. Even they sing, what happened? Their voice were shaking. Muni means dreaming. Coppery gong means an old-fashioned bell made of copper. Once again, coppery gong means an old-fashioned bell made of copper. Now, we see the explanation. The entire night, they sailed, and when the sun went down, again they started singing a dreamy song in a shaky voice. So, because of the weather, the voice was shaking. But which was resounded? Why it was resounded means because they were in the, because of the coppery gong which was there. So because of that, their voice was resounded. Once again, see, the entire night they sailed, and when the sun went down again, went down again means in the night, they started singing a dreamy song. Dreamy song means which they like very much. But while singing, the voice was in a shaky manner, which was resounded because of the coppery gong. See here, children. Now see the next. Oh, Timbalo, how happy we are. Here the expression used, oh, Timbalo, means oh, the friends. When we live in a sieve and a crockery jar, and all night long in the moonlight pale, we sail away with a pea green sail. Once again, oh, Timbalo, how happy we are when we live in a sieve and a crockery jar, and all night long in the moonlight pale, we sail away with a pea green sail. Here, see once again, the continuation is there. In the shade of the mountains brown, far and few, are the lands where the Jumblies live. Their heads are green and their hands are blue, and they went to sea in a sieve. Once again, in the shade of the mountains brown, far and few, are the lands where the Jumblies live. Their heads are green and their hands are blue, and they went to sea in a sieve. See how they are traveling in that, in a sieve. Very happily they are enjoying. Now see this. They felt very happy when they hid in a sieve and a crockery jar. When there was no moon in the sky and sailed in the green. No moon in the sky means night time. And sail in the green color sea. So what type of the color of the sea water? In green color, pea green. I think you know peas, how the color is light pale green in the manner. And in the shade of the mountains. Why the shade of the mountains means? While they were traveling, the mountain shade that falls on them. Still, they were in a sieve, sailing to the place where the Jumblies live by saying that their heads are green and their hands are blue. So even they were traveling in this manner, what they told? They are saying that they did not have done any mistake, but even by saying that they traveled in a sieve, and where they want to travel? To the place where the Jumblies live by saying that what they have told? Their heads are green and their hands are blue. Children, once again read this audio along with this video 2-3 times. Then you can easily understand. At last they said that Jumblies never care about anyone. But do you think these Jumblies are clever? I think that these Jumblies are not clever people, because a sieve, see, which is having holes, is it not safe? No. In a sieve to travel in a sea water, sudden water will get in, and what will happen? It's definitely drawn into water. So they never have done a clever thing. But these Jumblies thought or think that they were clever. You see, children, in the world of imagination, anything is possible. It means this did not happen real, but this is the imagination world. We can imagine any type of things. So here, at last, after this Jumblies, what they told? That this type of imagination is possible everywhere, but we can enjoy it a lot. So in this manner, the poet has given a funny poem for us to enjoy. Now children, see this assignment. Read the poem, the Jumblies, and the meanings in textbook. Okay children, thank you.